a patchwork of different sectoral frameworks, institutional-wise and legally.
The first thing you must think about when talking about governance of the Arctic is that the Arctic is mostly ocean, which means that the most important legal framework for tackling challenges in this region is going to be the international law of the sea. This global ocean law that has evolved through conflicts between states over centuries and whose most modern manifestation is the Law of the Sea Convention back in 1982. The important thing about the Law of the Sea Convention is that it allocated to different countries the competence to decide on matters that had to do with ocean use. And did so in a way that was extremely beneficial for the coastal states. The coastal states, through this most recent, most modern state of international ocean law, has very strong sovereign rights in terms of managing natural resources, whether we talk about living resources like fishes or we talk about mineral resources.
In May 2008, the five Arctic coastal states, namely Canada, Denmark, Greenland, Norway, the United States and Russia, signed the Ulusa Declaration. And what that declaration said was that the Arctic Ocean, as far as they're concerned, is not in a legal vacuum. They argued explicitly that as Arctic coastal states, they are well able to manage any outstanding sovereignty disputes that may exist in the Arctic, and indeed saw themselves as stewards of the Arctic Ocean. So that declaration, in a sense, was aimed not only within the Arctic community, but also critically to others. In 2010, for example, Norway and Russia finally agreed a delimitation on the Barents Sea and established a legal boundary between those two countries in terms of that maritime area. So that was one example where the Arctic Five turned to and said, look, we're able to resolve any difficulties we have. We have the Law of the Sea as an organizing framework. You don't need to worry about an Arctic scramble.
And the Arctic Council has been, well, focusing on some marine and research aspects in the beginning, has been developing slightly into a policy-shaping forum, but then again, it doesn't have any potential to cover legal agreements on its own right, so it's still something that needs to be implemented by the member states of the Arctic Council. So it's really, it's a forum for exchange, and it's seeing a changing role, but it doesn't replace much more developed areas such as the International Maritime Organizations, for instance, in the area of shipping.